Hey, what's up? I'm Eric. Today's project is to make your own shortcuts based on the BLE keyboard. You can make and use the features that are frequently used in Windows 10 as shortcuts. Of course, it can be created with shortcuts for Mac OS. It works the same as a regular Bluetooth keyboard because it's connected in the type of the BLE HID keyboard. I made 8 shortcuts, but I think it would be good to redefine the shortcuts you need. You can find the source code link in the description below. I'm going to tell you about the overall system configuration rather than the detailed explanation. If you have the questions, please leave them in the comments below. Okay, let's get started. I'm waiting for LVGL's new UI editor at Grind, but I couldn't use it for now because it doesn't have a function to convert it to C code yet. I'm preparing to do a new project with this when the official version comes out. In my case, I usually use Adobe XD to configure apps layout or screens. I think it's a good idea to decide where to put the text or image in advance. I wish I had a UI UX designer, but I have to do everything by myself because I work alone for this project. The screen is set to 480 by 320, the display I will use. I'd like to divide it into two parts. The top part is a header and it has a title and BLE connection status. I want to make a grid view with the body part below. One rectangle is 90 by 90 and there is an image button 64 by 64 inside. That's all. It's a very simple single page application. Here is today's project source code. It looks like there are also files, but most of them are image files. All the images used here are images obtained through the LVGL image converter. I have prepared all the necessary icons in advance. A total of 11 icons were used in this project. 8 are for shortcut keys, 2 are for BLE connection, and 1 is for when the key is pressed. All images are 64 by 64 and JPEG type. Basically, the setting for LVGL was shown in a couple of previous projects using LVGL version 7. Please refer to this part and configure your development environment using LVGL first. In order to make the font size of the label bigger in the header, the style should be changed. Please enable the required part in your LVGL config header file. This is my LVGL config header file. To use the big font, Monster 40 is enabled. One more thing is that we need to use LV object user data type, so line number 221 is LV use user data enabled. This is to assign a value to each of the 8 buttons to distinguish which button is pressed when the event occurred. In the header part, the set connect icon part is created as a separate function. This is change the icon according to the BLE status. If you look at the part where I create the grid view, creating one LV object and set it to grid layout. After that, the forum iterates as many as the number of the icons and draws the buttons one by one in this grid layout object. The pressed event shows the pressed image and each button is assigned the user data from 0 to 7 and all have the same callback function called key event callback. In the key callback function, you can see which key the event occurred on. It's all the role of LVGL to draw on the screen and give a callback when a button event occurs. It works very well. Let's look at the whole logic of this system. In this code I created, the BLE controllers object is responsible for triggering the BLE keyboard. After creating an object from the BLE controller, binding the BLE status callback function called updateConnection. This function is created to update the BLE connection status with the icon on the screen and is invoked by the BLE controller object. Also, this BLE controller includes the BLE keyboard library to allow predefined shortcuts to be input to the Bluetooth connected device. Let's say a button on the screen of the LVGL is pressed. The key callback function works on the main page and passes which button was pressed to the message task via message queue. This task continues to operate internally, and when an event occurs, it receives the queued event and invokes the member function called the trigger task of the BLE controller. The reason why I wrote this way is to separate UI logic and main logic to operate independently of each other. The UI should already operate as fast as possible. When complex tasks are required, it's important to separate them so that the UI does not slow down any time. It's the point. When the BLE controller is created as an object, it also creates the BLE keyboard object from the BLE keyboard library. This library has a BLE HID profile, which provides what it needs to operate as a BLE keyboard, so we can use it easily. It checks the current connection status every 100 milliseconds and informs it through the bound callback function. In the trigger test, it's creating an object from the My Shortcut class and passing it over to the parameters of the send task. Because this object contains a BLE keyboard, it can run predetermined shortcuts with it. You see that the member function called action in the MyShortcut class has a predefined shortcut. The button event trigger initiated from the main reaches this point, and the predefined shortcut is entered into a connected device. This is a whole logic for this project. Okay, then let me build my project. To build my project, you need to have a huge app partition scheme due to the icon size. It's pretty big. All done. Let's take a look at the working device. Let me check if the connection status is updated properly. If you look at the current connection status icon, it says it's not connected. When I connect it from PC, the connection status icon changes to the connection icon. If you shut down or forcefully remove the pairing from the PC, the connection status will be changed to disconnect and it has a connected icon. Yep, it works well. This My Shortcuts project is working without any problems. Please try to make it for yourself. It's quite good. In addition, keyboard makers programs like an auto hotkey seem possible. For example, you can create a set of the events and trigger all events in order with one click. The last thing I should mention is that the BLE keyboard library doesn't work very fast. For example, when making a keyboard, there should be no delay between typing, but there was a problem that it worked slower than expected. I think I need to check this part again. Anyway, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you in the next project.